I identify myself as a cyborg because I have a new sense that is created of cybernetics. Since 2013, my body is permanently connected to online seismographs that allows me to perceive the seismic activity of the planet in real time. So now I'm here in Oporto, but if there's an earthquake in Japan or in Greece, I would feel a vibration inside my body. I have a couple of implants in my feet that allows me to feel the seismic activity of the planet. And depending on the intensity of the earthquake, the vibration I feel is stronger or less strong. So at the beginning, I had to get used to feeling all these vibrations constantly into my body, to feel all this constant motion. But at the end, it became like a new sense, what I call the seismic sense, the feeling the seismic activity of the planet. So the planet is constantly moving. It is evolving. The tectonic plates are alive. They release and create tension, and they create earthquakes. And earthquakes are part of our nature, but they're still a very mysterious phenomenon. So I'm actually a dancer, and I study choreography and movement research. And when I was in college, I was encouraged to use technology in my pieces, but I always found that using technology as a tool, it was very cold and distant and unnatural. So I thought that rather than using technology as a tool, if I use technology as part of the dancer or as part of the artist, it would be a more natural way. So during my movement research, what I wanted to perceive, it was all the imperceptible movement that happens that our natural senses don't allow us to perceive. I did some projects. One project that I did, it was to detect the speed of the people walking in front of me. Then I did another project to feel presence behind me. Like I could feel if, yeah, like this changed my perception of my surroundings. But after doing these projects, I wanted to perceive something more universal, movement independent people on objects. And then I realized that the Earth is constantly moving. Not only rotates by itself and around the sun, but it also shakes constantly through earthquakes. And I found it fascinating, like, to be connected to this huge, enormous, and natural movement that most of the time is imperceptible. So this is when I created the Seismic Sense, and I put these implants on my feet. I can feel the reaction. it wasn't that painful. It looks dramatic, but it's not. So now so these implants allows me to be connected to the natural movement of the Earth. So after perceiving all this seismic activity inside my body, I feel like the earthquakes are like the heartbeat of our planet, what I call the earthbeat. A good way to describe what I feel is like I feel like now I have two heartbeats, my own and the earthbeat, having its own rhythm inside my body. I see this as a cyborg art. I feel like now artists no longer need to use technology as a tool in order to create art. We can use technology as part of our body and our mind and change our perception of reality. So the artwork of a cyborg artist would be the creation of a new sense. So I see the seismic sense as my artwork, but it's an artwork that happens inside my body. So in cyborg art, the artist, the artwork, and the museum where the artwork happens is exactly the same person. So I feel like I'm the audience of my own art. So in order to share my experience and my perception and of what I feel, I create external artwork. And one way to share this is through a dance piece that it's called Waiting for Earthquakes. So when I do this dance piece, I just wait still until an earthquake takes place. And when this happens, I move accordingly to the intensity of the earthquake. So it's a piece based on real time. So whenever there's some, depending on the intensity of the earthquake, my movement changes the intensity. So it's a bit like a duet between the earth and myself. So if there are no earthquakes during the performance, there will be no dance. Some festivals get very worried about this, but the earth moves very often. So it's okay. So in this performance, it's like the earth is like the choreographer of the piece, and I'm just interpreting the data that she gives me. Another way to share what I feel is through percussion. So in this case, Earth is the composer of the piece, and the rhythm of the piece is based on the rhythm of the tectonic plates. So people can hear how the intensity of the movement of the planet is. And also, I create some scores based on the seismic activity that had happened in a specific place on the planet. So for example, the first one I did, it was in Mexico, and I collected all the seismic data that had happened in Mexico in the last 50 years, and I put them all together in an 8-minute piece, so people could hear through the percussion of the drum how the seismic activity of Mexico was, so the Mexicans could hear the movement of the Earth. So in that case, the Earth is the composer of this piece. And in 2010, with my childhood friend Neil Harbison and I, we co-founded the Cyborg Foundation. Basically, with three aims. One is to help humans to become a cyborgs. The other one is to defend the cyborg rights, to defend the right of being able to design yourself. And the third one is to promote cyborg art as an artistic movement. We did different projects with this. And then after a while, we realized that I also feel transspecies, apart from being a cyborg. I feel transspecies because I have a new sense that is no longer defined as a human sense. And since 2017, last year, we co-founded the Transspecies Society. So it's like the social project of the Cyborg Foundation. It's a community when people can come, and we have a lab where we create new senses and new organs, and we also give voice to people that don't identify 100% as human, which there's a lot about that. So I don't feel 100% human because I have a new sense that is no longer a human sense, but there are many people that don't feel 100% human for other reasons. And I think it's important here that in our society we feel relevant the logo. I think it really describes our idea. We don't think that humans are a closed circle. I feel that we are more as in a spiral, that we can evolve. The humans are evolving during our lifetime, and we can decide and we can take part of this evolution. Yeah, but I wanted to say something else about the logo. There's some theories that say, well, there's some theories, I mean, I believe this theory, but it's a theory that, I mean, we haven't been always human. We started as a bacteria, we were on the sea, then we were on the trees, now we are humans, but then maybe we'll become something else. So this is a natural evolution of who we are. So maybe this is exciting for some people, and now we can decide, we no longer need to wait for natural evolution, we can evolve during our lifetime and decide how we want to be and how what we want to perceive. This is my friend Neil. He also feels transspecies because he has a new body part that is no longer defined as a human body part. He has an antenna in his head that allows him to perceive color from ultraviolet to infrared through sound, through vibrations in his skull, and then he hears it. With him, we did many projects. One of them, it was actually Neil and I think we have a bit of bad teeth. I have a tooth missing, and he has two tooth missing. And then we didn't want to have a normal tooth replacement. And then we were invited in Brazil to do a workshop, and then we proposed to create some tooth for us. And then what we did was that we did like a prototype that whenever I click, he would feel a vibration, and whenever he clicked, I would feel a vibration. So we both know the Morse code, so by the rhythm of our clicking, we were able to send each other words. So we were like, and we call this the transcendental communication system, because we were able to communicate to each other from tooth to tooth. This is like the performance that we did. We were sitting apart, and then the audience would write a word, I would click, and then he would write the word. So it's actually useful for people who cannot move any part of the body. Or maybe it's also a system that could work in space because you don't need air to communicate to each other. Actually, the tooth was also connected to Bluetooth through an implant, so it was actually a Bluetooth tooth. Neil had another space in his mouth, so we decided to fill it up and put some light. So whenever he clicked, he could light himself in case of total darkness. Another project that we're doing in the Species Society is a sense to feel the quality of the air. So if the air is very contaminated, you would feel a stronger vibration, and if you have a clear air, not. This is another prototype that a student did that it's to feel the heat of the sun, the solar flares. This is the retrospection when I could feel what I had behind. This is a friend that he really likes the weather, and he can feel the atmospheric pressure through vibrations in his ears. And the atmospheric pressure changes if it's going to rain or not, so he's actually the weatherman. Now that I feel that I'm a cyborg, I actually don't feel closer to robots or to machines. I feel closer to nature because I can feel my planet, and I feel closer to other species that I can relate how they perceive reality. So I feel that we can learn a lot from other species and how they perceive reality. Sometimes what we think is very unnatural is actually very natural. Like some animals can fly, some animals can perceive infrared or ultraviolet. So even immortality already exists in nature because there's a jellyfish that never dies and keeps regenerating themselves. So sometimes we can get a lot, inspired a lot by nature. Also, through our senses, we experience the outside world. And if we add new through our senses, we experience the outside world. And there are many things that happen around us that our senses don't allow us to perceive. So we feel that we don't do virtual reality or AR or augmented reality. We feel that we do RR, like revealed reality or real reality. Because through the creation of these new senses, we can reveal a reality that exists, but we cannot perceive it with our natural senses. For hundreds and hundreds of years, humans have always been changing the environment in order to live more comfortable. But we think that maybe it's time to change ourselves in order to live more according to the needs of our planet. Maybe if we all had night vision, like some other species have, during the night we wouldn't have to turn on the light, and then half of the planet would be dark, and the waste of energy would be much less. Maybe if we would control our own heating and not using air conditioners or heaters, we wouldn't be wasting so much energy that actually is damaging our planet. So maybe it's more natural to change ourselves like other species, adapting to the environment rather than keep changing the planet. Also, we think that if we use internet as a sense, we can feel things that happen very far from where we are. Our senses no longer need to be attached to our body. If we use internet as a sense, we can feel things that happen in the other side of the planet or even in space. And we feel that we can all become sensetronauts and explore space while we are on Earth. So I'm a bit of a sensetronaut because I'm not connected in real time, but my current project is to connect to the seismic activity of the moon because the moon also shakes and has moonquakes. So my current project is to connect to the seismic activity of the moon, and this will allow me to be physically on Earth but having my feet on the moon. So I feel that we can all become sensetronauts and have a new sense of explore the space exploration. We no longer need to go physically on space and be an astronaut, if not like be in Earth and then explore space that sometimes I think it's more comfortable. And just to end, I think that we are the ones who need to decide that the union between humans and technology has a positive impact. We are the ones who need to decide if the union between humans and technology doesn't distance from nature, but instead bring us closer to other animals, to nature, and to space. Thank you.